Alrighty, I promised a wood-burning video, so here we are, folks. Welcome to Cousin Jack Carves. Today, I'm going to be showing you how I use my wood burner and add some details to these little carvings and why I use the wood burner. So we'll get into all that. Today, I'll be wood burning a little robot and a little wizard character. These, again, are for my grandsons. I wanted to give them a gift that will be a DIY tic-tac-toe set. So here's a little wizard, and you can see I've put in a variety of little marks here for stars, and there's a little crescent moon shape for his wizard robe and hat. Today I'm using a walnut hollow wood burner, and this wood burner has 10 different settings for heat. It's a wire tip burner, and the walnut hollow is the one I selected because I wanted to get into a wire tip burner without spending $100 or more. And it has been very reliable for me. It comes with 4 different wire tips. This is the one that I use the most. It has a very thin profile and a pointed tip, which I find good for details. So let's get cracking. First thing I'll do is crank up the heat. I want this to be a little extra hot when I go around. I'm going to put in the detail on the edges of the beard and the edge of the hair. And I want that wood to be textured in a way. So I want that heat all the way up where it will slice in and create that texture. So I'm using the edge of this tool right now to go around that outside edge. Now the wood burner that I used to have and used to use when I first started out was about a $12 wood burner. Had, I guess they were pretty common to find, and you can still find them with, I think it's a brass tip on it, and it only had that one head with the one shape. So it's fairly limited with, you know, what I could do and how I could use it. I'm just cutting in this edge. And we'll do the same thing on the hair, just to texture the edge. And a wood burner can do a lot. If you have, you know, really fine details that you're trying to put into a piece, like animal fur, for example, wood burner is a really good tool for that. One of the other things that you'll find with the wood burner is that it can help you keep your paint colors from flowing together. So you can set a border, basically, with your wood burner that helps to prevent the paint from one color running over into another. Okay, we've gone around our edge. I'm gonna crank the heat back down to about number 8 here. And we just talked about the fact that we want to create a border, set the edge to keep paint from running together. For example, this hat will be midnight blue. This beard will be like a natural or oyster white. So what I like to do is go around and burn a line to separate those pieces where two colors come together. In addition to helping to keep your paint from flowing into areas that you don't want it to, you'll find that the wood burn details also can provide some shadow. So this line we're putting in right now creates some shadow underneath the wizard's hat. In addition to keeping our colors from running together when I go to paint. So I'm going to be quiet for a little bit here, and I'll let Sunny go ahead and speed this up for you. Alrighty, so we've got that border around the hat, went around the nose as well. And I think I'll just tighten up this line a little bit. Now you can see, every once in a while, you might not be happy with your line. Just to give you an example, if you accidentally touch something, let's say a piece of the wood that you didn't intend to touch, not a problem, okay? Don't worry about it. You can use your universal eraser. That's right, your carving knife, and you can get rid of that in a heartbeat. It's going to be really easy to fix. In this case, I'm not worried about that because that's part of the beard. I'm going to put in the beard detail. So what I like to do is kind of find that center of the beard and then just work my way down the middle first to remind myself of the way that I want that beard hair to flow, okay? So if I have the middle underneath his nose, and I just put in a few lines here. All right. Because I want the beard hair on this side flow towards the center this way, and of course the hair from this side to flow towards the center from that direction. So we'll go ahead and put in some whiskers on this guy. Just kind of a random pattern. All right, I think I'm ready to move on now and do some work on his hair. So same thing on the hair. I want to go and find the center just to give myself a reminder. I want the hair to flow towards that center from this side and then flowing in this direction from the left. And then, of course, on the sides, it's little bit of a tight squeeze here. Now, some of these marks will be covered by paint, but they'll still be somewhat visible, depending upon how thick you use your paint. You know, if you're using a light wash, these lines will still be visible and provide detail. And then even if you use a bit of a thick coat of paint, the wood burner does create texture. So it's more than just a look. You can actually feel that texture that you get from your wood burner. All right, come over here to this side. Now, if you're ever interested in seeing someone who is an incredible artist with a wood burner, check out the Helvy Nye's YouTube channel and watch what Rich Smithson does with a wood burner on a knife handle. It's incredible. He makes what he calls tattoo knives. And some folks know Rich has a bachelor's degree in art, so he's definitely a skilled artist, and what he does with a wood burner is just amazing. All right, so I want to go ahead and start putting in some of the stars on the body here. And to do that, I'm just really going to be tracing around the lines that I've put in place earlier with a pencil. And these stars, pretty tiny. And like I say, having this woodburn line will help the paint that I use when I paint the stars stay separated from the midnight blue color of the rope. I'll give you an example. So here you can see this is a midnight blue, and the white, of course, is painted inside the stars. There's the crescent moon shape. All right. Now to make the stars, let me just give you a quick look at what I used. So Sunny let me borrow her hole punch that has a star shape on it. Actually, she did it herself. She punched some holes into this cardstock. All I do is use that as like a stencil, right? Hold that up against the side of the piece and just trace with the pencil. To get a basic star shape. And then just go back with the pencil and kind of fill it in a little bit. Until I'm happy with it. And then, of course, when you go to paint, you have opportunities to refine your shapes there too. All right. So I'll just go ahead and work my way around here, working on some of these stars. And again, I'm going to be quiet for a bit so Sunny can speed up that process for you. So I'm going to go ahead and burn a line right underneath this fold in the hat. And that's really just to add some shadow. then the last thing I'll do for this little wizard before we move on to the robot is make a line to separate the colors and add detail. So we have this border between the hair and that robe. You want to make sure and put in a line around that border. We'll do the same thing around the beard. Well, there he is. We've got the wood burning detail into the wizard. And I'll show you what we do with the robot. The robot, you can see, is, like I said, it's more linear in terms of the types of lines that I'll make on here. And the detail helps keep the paint from running together, as we talked about. And this little guy also has some tiny little circles that I use a different tip from the wood burner to make. I'll show that to you. But first, we'll go ahead and put in the vast majority of the lines using this tip that we have right now. You can see this piece of basswood might look a little different than the wizard. You may have noticed, for example, that the grain has been raised quite a bit. When we look at the wizard and the robot right next to each other, you see the difference? I can tell you why. It's because I took the robot and gave it a coat of walnut oil, whereas the wizard was left natural with no walnut oil. So you can see from the look of this, it has a little more of an amber tint to the robot and definitely has a lot of grain showing. And that's from the walnut oil. If you've never tried walnut oil as a finish or as a pre-finish sort of a conditioner to raise the grain on your piece of wood, you might want to give it a shot. So with the robot and wizard I mentioned, these are going to be part of a tic-tac-toe set for my grandsons. And because of that, I decided to use X's and O's for the robot's eyes. I wanted the robot to have his game face on. Tic-tac-toe, X's and O's. Sometimes you can see as I go along here, because this wood has been coated with walnut oil, sometimes you can see a little bit of oil bubble up to the top with the heat from the wood burner. And I'll tell you, that's not a problem. It's just kind of an interesting thing that happens. You can see how it gets real shiny there with the oil when it sort of bubbles up from that heat. Actually brings the oil to the surface of the wood very briefly. just like when you're using sharp tools for carving, you want to be careful when you're using a wood burner. You don't want to accidentally touch that tip or burn yourself, of course, or any surfaces that you're not interested in burning. Fortunately, I've never had that happen, but it goes that way sometimes. So yes, be careful. All right, so this little robot has some tracks that he rides along on. You can see these tracks here. You can see the side detail. And again, the wood burner gives this some texture so that these tracks, they actually have some detail and a feel to them. So the wood burner works out great for that sort of a thing. And it's really all about kind of picking and choosing where you want those tracks to land. And then just kind of making your lines. I'm also going to go ahead and give this some separation between the two tracks right here. And I just picked up a little fuzzy. So one way to get rid of fuzzies, by the way, if you have any, your wood burner can help you out. It's a pretty effective tool for getting rid of fuzzies. We'll go ahead and separate the back as well. All right, now I come back up here on the front. I think you get the idea. I'm gonna be quiet for a bit here and then let Sunny speed this up for you. Alrighty, I want to switch to the other tip that I mentioned earlier. I'm just going to turn down the heat for a second. When you get this wood burner, it comes with these handy grippers that let you grab a hold of a hot tip, set it aside. I like to put mine into a glass jar and let it cool off. And then go ahead and put the new tip in place. So pretty easy and pretty quick to switch out the tips on the Walnut Hollow burner. It's called the Creative Wood Burner by Walnut Hollow. All right, so this little tip has a ball right at the end of it. You can see it's pretty small, but I think you can see that. And we'll just use that to make a few little dots here and there. So on this finished robot here, you can see we put in some dots here, 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 and here. And it works out pretty well. So right where these two lines intersect here, we'll just go ahead and place a dot. Pretty simple. And then at the end of each of these lines, and then on the base where we're going to have these, I guess they're cogs or gears that turn the tracks, put a mark at each end. Like that. The little dot inside the eye is actually made with paint. And that, folks, is pretty much how you do it. I already showed you how to do the tracks on this side, and you can figure that out. I'll do the rest of this stuff off camera. Thanks for joining me today. Certainly appreciate your support. If you have a second, please hit the thumbs up button right below the video. It really helps a lot. Thanks again, everyone. We'll see you next time.